Make a motion.
Okay, we're going.
Okay, we are recording. We are now on the mic. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, call this meeting to order. This is the July meeting for the Valley of Alachua County Zoning Board of Appeals. The only case that you have in front of you is the stub storage, which is a carryover from last month, so I'm not going to go through my big long speech. Just go ahead and put it in minutes that I did, because they've already heard it, and I don't do it again. The case that we're calling is VAR 2018-13, stub storage, 6125 Union Road, 8 Howard, Georgia. Ms. Carmella?
Yes, sir.
You're going to have to go back to the old way. We don't have all the electronic.
I know.
And my apologies.
Technical difficulties.
Good afternoon, everyone. Okay, there's been just one, basically two updates to this variance request. This is a variance request by Mr. Stacy Stubbs, proposing to do a development on Union Road. Since the last meeting, Board of Commissioners did approve his rezoning request. So the property is zoned CG, general commercial, with two conditions. And the conditions, has to do with a buffer along Union Road and along the I-75 side of the property. Second condition has to do with limiting the use of the property. No clubs, no lodges, no meeting or event facilities, no package stores, etc. And I tried to put that in your staff package. But again, he's requesting variances to the supplemental standards as they relate to self-storage, meeting storage facilities. Staff is recommending approval with some conditions. The conditions to follow the condition that was set by the Board of Commissioners in regards to buffers. I tried to include in your staff report an updated site plan. He has made some amendments to the rear yard setback, which is the setback along I-75. He was requesting a 10-foot setback, but he has amended that to 20 feet. He's backing away from that I-75 lot line area, going from 10 to 20, which still requires a variance, but a lesser variance. Staff is recommending approval to his maximum site area. Numbers could determine why the ODC placed a limit on the area for the storage facility. I think it was something recommended by the consultants, and we just adopted it. So there's no real reason as to why 5 acres or 10 acres, or why that's good or bad. But we are recommending approval so that he can develop the site for 8 acres instead of the maximum 5 acres. We are recommending approval to his access requirement variance. We require that the storage facilities be located on an arterial road system. Union Road is not, it's a collector. County engineer felt Union Road was appropriate enough to handle the traffic. It's the right of way is wide enough to accommodate it, so we didn't see a problem. With regards to setback, we are recommending approval to the front yard setback of 20 feet as proposed with a 10-foot buffer. Specifications of that buffer is like 4 trees, 25 shrubs, evergreen, 100 linear feet. And the developer didn't have a problem with that. We're recommending approval to the rear yard setback of 20 feet. We are recommending approval. We have a standard that says your outdoor storage couldn't exceed a certain percentage of development. But we want to condition that's no more than 50% of his development, and he's agreeable to that. Traffic circulation, we require that driveways be at least 25 feet. He's proposing 20 feet. We are recommending approval of that as long with the condition that he marks those driveways as one-way driveways. Madam Chairman, I do have some elevations of what he's proposing. Try to put that in your staff report. We're excited about this development and all the more than having some questions.
Okay, and the drawing that you've got is showing all the new stuff?
Yes.
So if we reference this, and all with your conditions.
That's like
that does.
Yes, it does.
Is that the same as this one?
Yes.
That's just smaller, smaller scale.
The applicant is here. You all have any questions?
Anybody have any questions or discussions?
Go ahead. Is the front yard, the Union Road side, and the set by 75 the backyard?
That's correct.
Okay. When you say on the front, y'all are approving a 20-foot setback instead of the required 75 feet with a 10-foot buffer.
That's correct.
Is that part of the 20 or in addition to the 20?
That's part of the 20. So it would be a 10-foot buffer, then in 10 more feet, this building starts. It's small, it's going to be tight.
Let me ask you why, on this particular property, there is a need for a 50-foot variance. That's not a small variance.
Oh, why is the property?
The property is, it's about 200, at the northern point, it's about 230 foot in depth.
At the smallest, the narrowest part?
The narrowest part?
It's probably at 185 to 200.
But you're planning on leaving the Frank's Creek corner, so to speak. You're going to leave that natural.
On the south end, yes.
On the south end, you're going to leave that natural for a distance of 100?
Yes, there's 13 and a half total, right? 13 acres on the total, 12.9 something acres on the total track, and Monk Development in the northern 8. So the southern 4 acres will not be touched.
Can the northern 8 be developed? Does it have flood land or whatever?
The northern side? It's good and it's high and dry.
Not the northern side of Frank's Creek, which would be the southern end of this property.
Yeah, no,
is it developed?
It's wet. No,
so that's why you're not developing.
No, but they still 2 or 3 acres on that. I just went for an 8 acre for just a good number to run with, you know, above the 5, because mainly for that reason, because my outdoor storage from all these stuff haven't really been getting in and out, pull through, dock thing apart.
I have a question for you.
Go ahead.
You were thinking that if this property is 170 feet wide,
deep,
and 75 would need to be on the front to be buffer with the road, why isn't he using just a long, skinny one row to go farther down into that second bit?
I guess my problem would be that if you've got some additional land, why not squeeze it out. I mean, I don't have a problem with a variance on the front and one on the back, but when you go to from a required 75 feet setback to basically a 10, that's what you're talking about, in an area that has zero commercial, and you're looking at RVs and boats and all that, it doesn't seem like you're going to be able to hide a lot. And if you ride I-75, all of that is rural. You know, it's...
Right, well, that's why they wanted to have the 75 side of it to be...
But those are large variance requests. It's not like 10 feet or 15 feet. That's a major request, more than we see normally.
And our idea was the topography of the property, the way it's shaped, it's very limiting all in itself. But yeah, that is quite a bit of variance. We didn't see where, you know, the
objections at the rezoning?
There was one. There was one objection. Yes, there was one.
One night?
I have a question about where the driveways are. So the inbound driveway is on the north end, and then you come in and you go to your thing, and then you come around and you go out on the southbound one.
Yeah, that's none of that's really called installed cars.
Okay, well, what I want to know is...
I got an engineer working on it to where you can see in and out from you coming in and out and turning in.
There was a lot of concern at the rezoning across the property when they did that. Like, a mass of people came about how the visibility is bad on that section of the road. And they were putting all those houses across the street there. There was a lot of concern about accidents, about visibility on that section of the road. So I'm concerned about having these entrance and exit far enough away from A, each other, and B, the entrance to that development across the street, because we already know that there's concern about how well can you see over there.
And, you know, again, that there's a model that they follow, because there is a curve of slight curve in that general vicinity, but county engineer didn't see a concern, so.
Well, right, but he didn't see a concern when neighbors came and said, we live on this road and we have a concern, it's our street. So I'm inclined to take the concerns of the people who live on the street as valid, you know, that's a dangerous bit of road there.
Any other discussions, any other questions at this time? Thank you, Carmella. Anything you'd like to add, or are you satisfied we got all the information?
Yes, sir. If you're not satisfied, I
any questions for the act? Was there any other contact to your office, negative or?
None.
What are they doing?
No, it was more of the rezoning. It was more concerned about the rezoning than it was about the variance.
So, I have.
Okay.
There were a lot of conditions on what the CG thinks they could put there on the rezoning.
Yes.
Is it basically they can only put this, or?
No, they just.
What can they put here? Because I'm thinking about, say this doesn't come through. Mm-hmm. Say that, you know, we sometimes see people think they're going to be able to do something, then mm-hmm. it doesn't work out. Something comes up, they can't. If we give these variances, then it goes with the property. And if there was to be, what other things could go here?
You can restrict it to this use only. But CG allows a lot. But what the commission did is put what you can. And that will be no clubs, no lodges, meeting or event facilities, no alcohol package stores, no gasoline stations. And they restrict that from keeping any of those things, which are your busier type uses.
Can we come back and restrict to just this use?
Can I say something? On the CG, a bunch of those listed is community service. Anything that will serve the community. Churches, anything that's good for the community. According to the CG, what I read on the profile of it, is anything that's good for the community. So anything, you know, it's YMCA type thing or something like that, that's going to be, it's very regulated, the CG. It has to be something for
community. Well, I'm just thinking that if we make these buffer changes, then, you know, I'm not, as far as I know, none of us has a crystal ball that actually works.
Right.
Something could happen where you don't end up doing this. And then we've made these very narrow buffers for something like what?
You could restrict that to.
Yeah, I think we could restrict the buffers and setback variances to this use, and should this use fail, then it reverts back to...
No, I was asking about the usage. Since they said what he couldn't do, they just...
Well, we can put these variances on, only on his mini storage, and if there's any other thing, then not so much.
That's correct.
Any other questions, any other discussions? And I entertain a motion on this request.
Well, I'm going to put, if I'm the one that makes a motion, I'm going to put an extra condition. I make a motion that we approve the variances as presented with one additional, and that's that there's, that the driveway from this isn't directly across from the driveway of the, and that there's sufficient space between the entrances. I don't know how to say that. I'm really concerned about the traffic on that road.
Yeah.
You know, people are going to, here's what's going to be bringing into this. I have stored my grandma's, all her stuff is on the trailer in the back, and I'm going to come, and I'm going to make a wide turn into here, and then I'm going to have my trailer, and these aren't going to be fast-moving vehicles. Speed limit on that street is busy. There's a development across the street where people are in and out. They're hurrying to get wherever the heck they're going.
I would, if I'm made sure, I do, historically, driveways, the county engineer supports them aligning with one another.
That's what I was going to say. Usually, if you've got...
It is a design engineering thing that I don't understand, but I know that's normal.
Okay, the thing I'm concerned about is that the driveway, okay, so maybe it is, maybe, I can't tell where, I don't want people pulling out of this and have their lights shining into the house, that first house. You know what I mean? When you're pulling out of this, how does it line up to those houses across the street? We had this concern at the orchard. How were the lights going to be shining? Mm-hmm.
Okay,
go ahead.
We got all that consideration, and actually, in my opinion, we direct across from that driveway you're talking about, you don't have the time to see traffic coming, just like because I put a gooseneck in there not too long ago, and I called the engineer, they give a time, I said, we got to make sure these entrances are going to be half the time for people to see in and out of it. So I got not county engineer, but engineer working on all of that for me, because I don't know the distances as he does per se, where the county can do anything like it should be done. And yes, about as far as the lights going in and out of the stuff, I'm going to do my best to put a time restriction on my clock where there's nobody going to be coming in and out after hours, say 8 o'clock at night. So after 8 o'clock to 6 o'clock at night, they just shut down where nobody can get in and out.
So it's not going to be 24-hour hours?
Probably not. No, man. That's going to be up to me, really. And I really don't want it, because she's going to be there most of the time during the day, running, for the office and everything, and somebody, there's nobody going to live in building type storage type things. So I really would like to have a restriction on the time in and out. I don't really like a midnight use, especially if we had boat storages and such as that, somebody coming in through the middle of the night, breaking somebody's lock, getting out of the boat, you know, that type.
Okay.
I don't know how to express
myself
about that.
Gretchen, personally, I think you just got to leave that up to the county engineer and his engineer to say, do this the safest way, and depend on the county engineer and his engineer to tell them what to do. I don't know that we have the expertise. I'm not going to claim to have the expertise to tell them how to line it and not line it and all that kind of stuff. I hate to put that in here, but your entrance has got to be right here, and then find out that the engineer decided, well, that really isn't quite where we want.
It's like that engineer.
I'm going to move on. I'm going to take my.
that part or the whole?
Yeah, I'll take it. So, I make a motion that we approve the variances as presented. Say criteria D.
With staff, all of the staff, all of this stuff that's on here.
And the site drawing that we got today.
And I second the motion.
I have motion, we have second. All in favor, raise a hand, please. All opposed? We got a vote of 3-1.
1?
Well, technically, she just walked in, so she can't vote just because she didn't hear what we're doing.
So that would be the decision?
Yeah. So 3-1-1 is your vote. Good luck with it. Please make it look good. Please make it work.
We are going through our best, y'all. We really are. I thank y'all for everything. Appreciate your time.
Thank you.
All right. Okay. Minutes. We had a novel last month.
And the month before. And the month before.
Yeah.
It was miracle.
And I'll tell y'all on the issue disclaimer from like I said, y'all never see any typo, any comma that I've whacked, anything, and it doesn't come about. Please give me a call and let me know, because sometimes comments just go by.
Okay, we have minutes to approve. Anybody got any additions, deletions, corrections, substitutions? Can I get a motion to accept the minutes as presented?
Move.
I have a motion on the floor, Mr. Alvarado. Can I get a second?
Second.
I have a second from Mr. Holt. All in favor, raise a hand. 5-0 unanimous. Any new business, any old business, anything else we need to talk about on the agenda?
We don't have any cases for next month. The county doesn't. Our September meeting is not the week of Labor Day, but the next quarter.
Anything else we need to talk about?
This is an easy one.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your attention and support. We stand adjourned.
Have a good summer.
We're going to try it, don't you?